Okay, number five. Let's looking at the problem. They're given 1.14 moles of SO3. So remember, you always start with what's given. Ignore this stuff for now. So we're starting with moles, and then they want to know, this one's kind of unique, how many actual atoms, but the first thing we're going to do is convert to number of molecules of SO3. So before we go through the flow chart, if we're talking about molecules, how many molecules, this would be one. If I copy paste that, there's two now. But the question is saying how many atoms in that element. Or let's just say, what if the question were to ask that? So we'd have 1, 2, 3, 4 molecules for every, or atoms for every one molecule of SO3. So in this case, if I have two of them, I have two molecules of SO3, but in total, I'd have 8 atoms. So you know, kind of having that in the mind, let's start with what's given. We're starting at mole. The first thing you need to do is convert to number of molecules. So if you have 1.14 moles of SO3, our equivalence again is coming from right here. For every one mole of SO3, you have 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd molecules of SO3. And then so you may actually just stop there with that, and you could put in 1.14 times 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd. But if they want to know the actual number of atoms, so we're going to multiply for every one molecule of SO3, there are 4 atoms. So molecules of SO3 cancel. You could actually show that here. And if I copy this, oops. If you want to show the canceling out earlier of moles, you'd show that there. So then we're left with total number of atoms.